This is Indy's weekly Chalk Talk. Take it away, Indy.
Well, John, early in the show, you talked about the great job the New York Jets defensive backs did defending the pass. I want to talk about the guys up front, the front seven, and what I noticed when I watched that game. They did a great job playing disciplined, sound football, and they did a good job with gap control. And when we talk about gap control defense, we're talking about each man up front having a gap and making sure that a running back does not run through that gap. So I'll explain. First of all, the New York Jets, they play a 3-4 defense, so they have three down linemen and four linebackers, and those are the guys that I credit with stopping the run. They were not able to get any yards running the ball, and it was because of their disciplined gap control defense. This outside, strong side linebacker, he did a good job defending the tight end, but versus the run, he defended the alley. And when you talk about the alley, that's the last gap that you see on a football field. You have the A gap that's right between the center and the guard, the B gap between the guard and the tackle, and the C gap between the tackle and the tight end. And then you have the alley, which is outside of the tight end and obviously inside the out of bounds. And the outside linebacker, from what I saw, he did not let Danny Woodhead and co. get much yardage running through the alley. And this defensive end, it was very interesting to watch him. He showed two gaps, similar to the way cornerbacks and linebackers show blitz, but they don't blitz. He showed two gap by his alignment. He lined up head up on the tackle, and you don't even know which gap he was responsible for, but he was aggressive to the C gap, which freed up the strong side linebacker to defend the B gap. And this nose tackle did a very good job actually playing two gap. He lined up on the center a lot of the times, and he was responsible for both A gaps. And again, when I say you're responsible for a gap, that means the running back can't get yards in your gap. And he did a good job defending the A gaps. And the weak side defensive end and weak side linebacker played the same technique that you saw over here on the strong side. And that frees up this middle linebacker to just roam around and follow the ball just in case it leaks in these gaps. And they did a very good job. And what was also so exciting to see, though they were playing great against the run, they still had five sacks against Tom Brady. So they played a complete game, stopping the run and putting pressure on the quarterback.